And we're going to watch these peeps. Okay. We're going to see how we feel about them. So he's significantly older. And you can see it because he's got this gray hair. So let's see how we feel watching them. But let me also check out your comments, guys, because I'd like to do that. Let me see. Okay, let's see. Joelle says, it's very interesting despite the age gap. They both have similar pretty traumatic events, like with the earthquake and the terrorist attacks. I wonder how much that plays a role in their attraction. Exactly. It's like, are you bonding on trauma? But is that trauma bonding? That's the thing. Is like, what are you bonding on? Are you bonding on something that's similar for you? Are you bonding on trauma? Are you bonding on kinks? Are you bonding on... So I do believe like people fall in love, but I think like we bond on different things. What draws you to a person? What energy do they have? Are you able to maintain this into a long-lasting relationship and or a temporary one based off of how you operate your relationships? Like, I already know for me, it's like, But for other people, we want to be open for them to have the possibility of joy and happiness, no matter how alternative their lifestyles look, right? Because I think that's what's so important. Luna says, I do think they seem awkward. Maybe it's just because they're on camera, but I don't see them lasting. They have this off vibe. Yeah, I can't tell from just that short video, to be honest. But I do think, like, real life catches up with you. And I think that's what people forget. Love, sex, falling in love is easy. But making a relationship work in regards to being, like, I just think about my life in my 20s and how messy it was. And I needed it to be messy. I needed a chance to go explore. And I hated the idea. Like, I would hate my partner if they were older than me. And they were the reason I couldn't go explore my life. And I need to, like, be single sometimes or be in relationships. Like, I want to be my own agent. But that's me. That's my personality type. So I think that's the difference. Maddie's here. Hi, Maddie. Hi, Brittany. I dated someone for 3 years that was closer to my parents' age than me, 16 years. And went well for the most part besides his alcoholism. We only noticed the age gap relationships or when friends made it a deal. Yeah, that seems to be the consistency of it all is that – friends and family and culture seem to be the number one reason that these relationships don't work. And I think that that's something we should definitely pay attention to, right? Because we don't want to be those people who are being assholes and judgy. And so people don't get to like live their life, you know? T says, Brittany, I thought I wasn't in bubbles anymore until I watched a video about quantum mechanics and I learned how our understanding of time is false and time might not progress in a straight arrow. Yes, time isn't time. That's why I say like life is moments of time. It's not really like a linear process. And so, you know, I like to think of life as like moments in time. You know what I mean? Destiny says, okay, but most people who are really educationally smart aren't so mentally smart, or it seems like that sometimes totally, like doctors are known to be financially a mess. Like this girl used to make like 25K a month easy, and she was like, why don't I have any money? And I was like, because you don't know how to budget. You were so busy becoming a surgeon, you forgot how to like take economics, I guess. I don't even know. It's just, it happens that way. That's what I mean, though. I mean to say that ultimately, how introspective a person is, and how much they understand about themselves, I think is more a key component than the actual age. But for me as a human, I have yet to meet a person who is young, who can combat with me. So I just, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I hardly meet people that are old that can do that. So you know what I'm saying? It's not like, but maybe that's just me. You know what I mean? It's not like, I've just had a lot of time in my life to do things, you know? Okay, let me see. Maya Medicine says, trauma bonding is when someone is abusive to another person and then they bond over that abuse or trauma. Oh, I always thought trauma bonding was either or. Like you either trauma bond together or you're people who have had trauma and you're bonding on that trauma. I guess I've understood it wrong. So, okay. But whatever that is called when you both have trauma and so you fall in love because you're both fucked up in the same way, whatever that is, toxic or whatever, however you want to explain that, I see that happen a lot. You know what I'm saying? Molly says, even though it's a queer relationship, that does not necessarily remove the power imbalance. Absolutely not. Like queer or straight, it does not remove the power imbalance. But the power imbalance can only exist in a particular way and it always exists, period. And so the question is, what kind of power imbalance are you willing to have in your relationship and how would you like it to function? So to be clear, I do not want an intellectual power imbalance in my relationships. But I'm happy to have a financial one. I'm happy to have a strength one. I'm happy to have different kinds of power imbalances in my relationships, but I don't want one for when it comes to intelligence or at least, you know what I mean? I just don't want to be, I want a partner who like when I'm positively manipulating them to like eat their vegetables goes, bitch, are you manipulating me? And I'm like, only in the best way, babe. You know, I don't want a partner who doesn't understand that we say things certain ways or do things certain ways in our relationships to encourage positive behavior in a way that could be manipulative but isn't actually malicious. You know what I'm saying? Like, I need someone who's reasonable, who can, as an example with my last podcast, understand that older generations hold trauma and they don't believe in therapy. And so we have to be aware that they're not – they might be adults and older than us, but that does not mean they understand themselves in a way that could help them understand us. And so, like, again, that openness and that humility, that comes with, I think, a lived life. And so it's hard for me to imagine that a younger person could have it. But let's check out this next couple. I think she's a little older. I think she's in her 30s. So I think this would be much more important, too, to talk about that. Let me see. Okay, let me see. Maya Medicine says, bonding over similar traumas is not necessarily unhealthy. Well, no, nothing is necessarily unhealthy. But the point is that I do think it is wrong to form a relationship, my personal opinion, to form a relationship completely on your traumas, because what happens when you heal those traumas? And I've absolutely seen relationships where one partner is upset at another partner for healing their trauma because now their relationship has to change. If you have daddy, I see this in BDSM all the time. If you both have daddy kinks and then you grow out of your daddy kinks, it's fine. But what if one person keeps it and one person doesn't? Because a lot of kinks can come from trauma, though it doesn't always work that way. It could come from positive interactions as well in life. So I think it's not, again, this channel isn't interested in black and white answers, but for your own personal life, you should have some answers that work for you and your boundaries. So for Brittany, I do not want to bond with someone over their trauma. I want someone who's already healed from trauma enough to understand it's a trauma moment and we're not connecting on that trauma. We're connecting on our recovery from trauma or our ability to put trauma in the back burner of our lives. So I think that's important and specific. I also saw a TikTok that really stood out to me about this, how relationships online, she said the longer the Instagram post about how good the relationship has been or the ups and downs of a relationship are signs that like people are in unhealthy relationships. And I actually do fuck with that energy, where I do think when I see like Megan Fox and MGK talk about how like dark and deep and up and down their relationship is, I'm like, yeah, because y'all are trauma bonding, like, or bonding on trauma. And you don't know who you guys are when you're not traumatized. And the thing is, like, humans are not their trauma, in my opinion. Like, I'm not myself when I'm triggered. If I was myself when I was triggered, then I'd be that person now. But I'm a completely different human when I'm triggered. And it's nothing like this person. So, again, it's hard for me to want or not think it is, like, toxic to make your trauma a reason why you've bonded and fallen in love with a person. You know what I mean? Crazy Candy says, you literally just described my relationship. I've healed my trauma and worked on myself. My boyfriend is not there yet. I really hope he gets there. I think it would be so lovely for you guys to be able to both be in a positive space together. That's so nice. Bye, Maddie. Have a good weekend. Mwah! Chelsea says, I feel like grown as a couple, whether it's healing from trauma or bettering in any way, can be a major pain point if only one person is actively working on that and the other person isn't interested. Exactly. For sure, for sure. Okay, let's go ahead and let's talk about Bailey says, how do you feel about the idea that sexuality is classist? Kind of feels like the argument considers intelligence as the only existing through academia and wealth. I mean, sapiosexual is also like, they said it's like, some people think it's like racist and it's classist. Some people think it's, I don't know how the internet is taking sapiosexual, because I know Evie Lupine, who I love and is a good friend of mine, she doesn't use that term anymore because of the way that it's like been twisted by IQ supremacists. But I used to call myself sapiosexual because I was told that it's like attraction to ideas and intellect. But I'm really just trying to say, like, I'm attracted to my limitation of that. But I am attracted to ideas. Like, I don't care how hot a person is. I don't care how sexy they are or how many boxes they fit. If they're an idiot, I am going to dislike them and I'm not going to get wet for them. You know what I'm saying? So I think no matter how you identify, and all these labels are meaningless at the end of the day, if you fall in love with someone, let's just talk about it through that lens, you're falling in love with a person. And you should know why you're attracted to them and why you're falling in love with them and what limitations, like in regards to what limitations they have, how and why you are interacting with those people all the same. So, okay, I'm dating someone, they're everything I want, but then there's some part of them that isn't quite there yet. I have to love them for that inadequacy or that limit or that specific quirk I don't mean to put a negative spin on it. I kind of feel like I am with my tone, but it's like you have to accept a person. When I was in a lot of my relationships, I had to ask myself, do I radically accept and love the person as they are now? And the person they are now, what if they were that way for the rest of their life? Would I love them, or am I dating them for their potential? Excuse me. And I think for me, I lived a life where I was constantly dating people for their potential. Like, we're young, we're in our 20s, we're going to grow out of this. But as I was growing out of my 20s habits, everyone around me was not, and I was confused. And I also was like a really, I was also toxic. And like, so I'm not trying to say like I did it faster. I did not. I was like a very slow kind of burn myself. So I understand it takes time. But it happened, and when it happened radically and quickly. So I think that's kind of the conundrum. Like, I went from, like, 28 to 32, but 28 to 30 in particular was the fastest 2 years of my development that I've ever had. It's like I sped through all the life lessons in 2 years that I was supposed to learn periodically through my 20s, but I couldn't until I had gotten therapy. And then once I got therapy, it's like I zoomed through all my lessons, and I graduated college soon. But it wasn't college. It was, like, life college. You know what I'm saying? Okay, so let's go ahead and let's start on this video, which is called 34 Year Age Gap, How We Met Was a Love at First Sight. This is it Myra or Maya and Donnie? Here, she'll say her name, I'm sure.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Myra from Low Carb Love, and today we're doing something a little different. If you didn't already know, this is my fiance, Donnie. Babe, say hi to everyone.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Donnie.
Okay, so do you want to let them know what we're doing today?
Sure. Today we're going to talk about how we met.
Okay, cute. No judgment.
So a lot of you have always asked us a ton of questions. You guys want to know how we met and a lot of just like juicy details into our relationship. So Donnie and I wanted to sit down and just chat with you guys and let you know basically like how our relationship first started. So for those of you that know absolutely nothing about us, Donnie and I have been together for almost 7 years now, and we are engaged. We're planning on getting married next year. We don't have like any set plans or like venues or anything like that. But of course, when that time comes, then we'll bring you guys along. But taking it back to the beginning where we first met, it was 2014. And so Donnie obviously lived out here in Laguna Beach, and I lived in Downey. So for those of you that know, it's like, I don't know, like 15 minutes away from downtown LA. So anyway, how far is it from here? Like 15?
Well, it's probably around 40 miles, but the traffic makes it about 2 hours.
Yeah. So how we first met, Donnie was working out with a friend of mine, and he was his personal trainer. And
I'm working out and I see this absolutely beautiful girl come walking through the door to meet her friend. And she's the most beautiful girl I'd ever seen in my life. And I can still remember exactly what you wore. It was like these leggings, these booties. It was summertime. She had this little top on. I said, oh my God, who is she? And that was after she left.
Yeah. So I came down.
Okay, let me just pause it because your comments are great. People are saying she has a very like mature energy, like they seem really well balanced. They look the same, their vibe is similar. I grew up in Orange County, like for the first 15 years of my life. I've grown up all over Southern California, but in particular, like the Newport like area, that kind of like beachy area, they match it so well. So that's really interesting to me. All right, let's click it.
Down to work out with my friend. And again, this was Donnie's personal trainer at the time. Like, I of course hated driving from LA, but long story short, I drove down here. He's like, come down, we'll go to lunch, we'll go hiking, blah blah blah. So I was like, okay, let's do it. I walk in and Donnie's like,
sorry, Chelsea's saying that they're funny when they do TikTok dances, and then someone else said like they're on TikTok, so that's cute, like that they're able to like vibe together.
Like finishing up his workout, I'm gonna change because I was dressed. So I went to go change, and when I came out, Donnie was already gone. But my friend was like, hey, did you see the guy that was working out? And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, oh, he said hi. And I'm like, okay, like, okay. because obviously Donnie was a lot older, right? And so anyway.
I had no idea how old she was. She looked like she could have been 23, 28, I didn't know.
So.
Oh, well, hold up. So hold up. If they've been together 7 years and she was almost 30, so she's like, she's almost 40. You know what I'm saying? That's a grown woman. Like, she a grown woman, you know?
So, anyway, Donnie asked my friend for my number, and I was like, what the heck? No, you know? Because, like, duh, we were, I just felt like it was just such a huge age difference. I didn't even know his age, and I was just like, no.
She thought I was 40.
Okay, so do you like this? Look how good they are about the weirdness of their relationship. This is such good energy. Yes, Martina, we said it at the same time. These two have such good energy together. I love it. Yes, I love it. Oh, hi, Jedi Bunny. Mwah. Yes. Oh, this is like really good.
But anyway, so long story short, he continues to ask my friend for my number, and then I was like, okay, give him my number, and we I said, at least I will say hi to him. So Donnie texts me, and so we text message back and forth, and he was like super funny, like kind of jokester. And so I like that about him. And so finally one day I'm like, okay, like let's talk on the phone. Like, I'm not gonna go out to, oh, cause he was inviting me to go out to lunch. So I was like, I'm not gonna go out to lunch cause it's gonna be awkward. Like, I'm gonna go out and I don't even know this person. I know nothing. Like, I'm not trying to set myself up like that, right? And, but Donnie was like jokester. Like, he was, yeah, he's, you guys, if you know, follow us and you know, he's like always joking around.
I said it
around.
Wouldn't be painful. We'd have a great time no matter what.
He was saying like, it's.
I love this, guys. You're so right. The fact that she was trepidatious at first, this is from Chloe, at first is a good sign. I'm glad she gave him a chance. Like, yeah, I think that's what it is. I think the hesitation makes me more comfortable that you're being reasonable. But at the same time, is that our American bias? Like, is that the bias of my expectation of what a relationship looks like? Or is that me saying anytime you get into a relationship, you should be concerned why this person, this stranger that's never met you, that's lived a whole life before you, wants to like you? Like, I think there should be some sort of like, oh, but why? Especially with the objectification meter being so high, you know what I'm saying? One of you says, my dad and his wife are 20 years apart, started dating when she was 21, and they're literally the same person, same vibe, everything. These two are the same. I love that. Like, they look very secure in like the first couple. Yes, they feel very secure, but they've been together for 7 years, so maybe that's it. Margie says, I had a 7-year relationship with a 42-year-old man when I was 21. Best relationship of my younger life. I'm 71 now and still miss him. I feel that. Like, I believe that. You know what I mean? Oh, and yes. Oh, my God. Star, is it just me or is white totally that guy's color? Dude, I was just thinking he pulls off white so well. Like, he looks good in white.
It's not going to be painful, but I'm like, bro, I don't even know you. Like,
I said, so. It would be in public down near the beach.
Sorry. Hold on. I have got to turn down my light a little bit. It's like bothering my eyes. It's too bright. I know. I knew I turned it up too high. Hold on. Falling over. Oh, it's like making me sweat like no one's business. Ugh, YouTube life. Okay, hold on. Let's see if I can get back on this chair. Whoops. Haha, bitter. Okay, hold on. I had to pause it because I can't hear what they're saying. Sorry, the light was bothering me so much. Oh, I broke. Oh, no. Okay. Ooh. Oh my gosh, can we see that skirt? Yes. Yes. It's cute though, right? It's like a butterfly, and then check out my earrings for today. It's like a woman. Can you, hold on. Wait. Can you see? It's like a woman. I know the light's flashing. Isn't it cool? I follow this girl on Instagram. Go look at my Instagram and look at who I follow. Oh my God. See how that took it out of me, which is so funny. Like, I'm like exhausted from just standing up. But yeah, go check out my Instagram. I love this girl. It's art by Mia Thermopolis. That's how I remember her name, Mia. Okay, let's keep going with this comment, because or this video, because I love them so much.
Yeah, because I'm thinking, like, who is this person trying to take me out to lunch? I'm
stranger
like,
danger!
I'm gonna end up on a hill, like, in a trunk.
Look at that. They literally wrote stranger danger on their video. They are so confident. They are so confident. I'm in love with them. Like, I'm in love with their confidence. Oh, thank Destiny Girl. How are you? Thank you so much for that super chat. She says, the skirt is so cute. And oh my gosh, the earrings. Thank you, girl. Thank you.
Drunk.
No, so, don't give me a good review.
Yeah. So
she's making that up.
No, I didn't think that. But anyway, so we get on the phone and I couldn't believe that we talked for like 5 hours. Like, we talked for hours on the phone. So after that, I was like, okay, like, at least I know that we can carry on the conversation, right? Because you guys know, if you go on a date and then it's all awkward and you're like, oh my God, I can't wait to get out of here. Like, I've never seen this person again.
She didn't want to leave.
But anyway, we met up. And so we finally met up. We went out to lunch. There's a place called The Deck. And they have really good food. It's on the beach, really cute. If you guys are ever in Laguna, it's, you know, it's a cute place to go to. We met up for lunch and we ended up closing the place down. Like, we had lunch, then we ended up having like a little drink and we just stayed talking for hours. And I was like,
she could talk for hours.
Well, I can, but he was doing a lot of talking. Okay.
I was.
So we ended up talking to super, super late. We ended up saying, okay, you know what? After that, I was like, okay, I don't know where this is gonna go. Cause I was still really, the age difference was still a really big thing for me. I felt like really, I don't wanna say like awkward, but it definitely was something that was there and I had never dealt with it before. So anyway, but I said, okay.
I'm sorry, I know I'm pausing it a lot, but I love this comment right here. Lo says, I've heard great things about relationships that start on the phone. LOL, less potential to let lust interfere with love. Girl, don't even get me started on how lust has fucked up my dating trajectory.
Okay, let's do dinner. We can do dinner. So then I got dressed up, he got dressed up, and the next day we met up for dinner and we closed the place down again. And I was like, what the heck? Like, we can talk so well. Like, it always just flows. So I was driving home and I remember I called my mom and I was like, mom, cause I didn't tell about the first day, right? And I was like, mom, I met someone. And she's like, oh my God, mija, like, you know, who is it or whatever. And then I was like, okay, like, it's this guy, it's this man. I'm like, it's a man that is a lot older than me. And then she's like, oh, that's good, you know? But she didn't know like how much older. And she was like, but I think I kept pushing the age, like, no, mom. He's like,
I'm sorry. I know she's about to tell us, but I just want to, like, because I'm like, my brain is reacting as I'm seeing this. If she's 30, if she was 30 and they're 34, that means he was like 64. Wait, which means right now he's like 70? He looks pretty good. Is that that, you know, is that that LA magic? Is that Laguna magic? Is that Newport Beach magic? He looks pretty good. He looks like his energy is very high. Okay.
Like, a lot older than me. And then she's like, well, how much older? And so I was like, I didn't know his age because I didn't ask, like, how old are you? You know, I thought that was kind of rude. So I didn't ask, but I knew he had to be at least like 25, 30 years older. And she's like, are you okay with it? And then I was like, I don't know yet. Like, I don't know if I'm okay with it, but I did tell her, I don't know where this is gonna go. I said, but I know that we will always be friends. Cause it was like an instant like connection. So after that, guys, we met up like every single day. I mean, like, I don't think we ever stopped seeing each other after that.
No, it was kind of fun. It was really interesting. I mean, from my perspective, it was, I had just broken up from a long-term relationship.
And he wasn't looking for a relationship, guys.
And I was like, 3 months out and I was dating, and then Myra just rocked my boat when I met her, and we sat there and talked and just had the best time. Had the nicest time, so.
I was all counselor,
we could,
guys.
We
could, I was
relate.
Like, shrink life.
We could relate. Okay. She could do that. But we could just relate to each other. It was really fun. So Myra had a job that she was working for herself in Downey. And she was able to drop Natalia off at school, come down, work out with me. We'd have lunch. And she'd drive back, and she was doing this for months. I mean, almost every day for months.
I put 60,000 miles in my car.
about 5 months. So we really got to know each other as friends, and it was really nice that we got to know each other that way. Mm-hmm. I enjoyed it a lot. I got to know you, and I fell in love with you. And I know that you were doubtful. Myra was 29, I was 62. Mm-hmm. And the funny part was Myra says, we need to meet in Laguna Beach, because if you came to my area and you walked into any kind of a restaurant or a store, it would be in the newspaper.
Guys,
so,
I live.
So she kept coming down here, and sometimes even twice a day.
Yeah, a few times I did drive out here twice a day, because you know Nappy, she's my life, my world. I had to make sure that I was there to drop her off at school, to pick her up, and then put her to sleep. So there were a few times where like I'd put her to sleep and then drive out here. And
there's
so,
a kiddo.
But yeah, I mean, at the end of it all, that's kind of how we met.
We just had this great connection.
That's
it was
how
amazing.
We connected at the beginning. Yeah. But yeah, I think it took me a while to get used to like the age, the gap. And it wasn't us, it was everyone else. Like the stares, the looks, like
the guys were doing this, the women were doing this.
When we'd go out, like of course I could.
I'm sorry, pause. Yes, I agree with all your comments. Love their energy. I love this, yes, they like talk like they're friends, they're normal, they're joking. People who have such defensiveness over their choices bother me. They have no defensive energy. They are completely open, completely happy, completely comfortable with their decisions. They really made a decision that like worked for them. It shows in their skin. Like they are very happy. I love this for them. Like, can you see like, right now, it's hard for me to judge their decisions because I'm looking at them and saying, well, obviously they're fucking happy. So like, and they're like joyously happy. They're giggling. The fact that they can make a joke about their choices tells me that they made a choice they really believe in. And I love this for them. Now, I did see a comment that I thought was interesting, so I want to pause and talk about it. Julian says, it's sad that the older person will probably die first, unethical potentially in that regard. But I want to point out that men in general tend to die before their female partners. So, and usually by like 10 to 15 years sometimes. So I don't know if that's really the way to look at it. But I will say that I can understand that thought process for sure. I will say like in terms of unethical cohabitation, I guess you could say that maybe the fact that he might need help in a way that might be harder for a younger person to handle. Like if you've ever taken care of aging parents, you might know dementia or Alzheimer's can be a problem. Having to bathe them or change their diapers or hire a nurse could be a problem. But I would also make the assumption that they're living in really rich neighborhoods in Orange County. So they have money. Like, obviously, look at their, like, where they're filming. Look at their clothes. I mean, these are, like, Lululemon energy to me, but, like, in a really wholesome way. And I also, like I said, I grew up around Orange County. So they're naming all the expensive places to live. So I'm assuming these people have, like, all of the fears that normal, poor people, middle-class people would worry about. They don't have to worry about it. So I do think if you're well off, you have a potential of making unorthodox and alternative relationships last longer than people who are poor and can't handle the consequences of dating somebody who is older and might need medical attention in a way that a younger couple might not have to face for a very long time. I think that's really important. Let me see. Aliens existed. The fact that they still giggle and have these honeymoon phase moments 7 years into it is really lovely. Absolutely. I think that's like so just obvious. You know what I mean? Killjoin says, I think sadly people think that the mere existence of a power dynamic makes relationships invalid, which is like really just like I think true for specific bubbles. And of course on this channel we never want to adhere to the idea that one bubble fits all, so we really want to be open to the fact that some people can make these relationships work, as we've seen with them. You know what I mean? KJack says the fact that there's a 30 years between them isn't a red flag for me at all. The biggest issue I have is when the younger person is so young that they haven't formed their own identity, which I think is ultimately what we're all concerned about, because I don't think anyone here with a reasonable ethical value system is not worried about the younger person. I think we're all worried about the younger person, but I think we should also be worried about the older person. I think when you've seen elderly abuse and it's on the rise in this country, I think when you know that older people get duped into relationships with younger people who will leave them, that I think we should also equally care for the older person as well. In America, at least, we have a tendency to believe that older people are wiser. And I'm going to tell you this right now, that ain't the truth all the time.
See people looking at us and like totally judging the fact that we were together, you know? And I was just like,
oh. Actually, I thought that she was too old for me.
Whatever. We just couldn't get used to.
I'm sorry, what did Boo Boo say?
I could see people looking at us and like totally judging the fact that we were together, you know? And I was just like,
oh. Actually, I thought that she was too old for me.
Is that a joke?
Whatever. We just couldn't get used to. I
can't tell if that's a joke, because does he mean that? Like, does he mean that? See, that's like my anxiety just went up, because I don't know if that's a joke where he's like, oh, I actually thought like 30 is too old. And I'm like, no. Let's give him the benefit of the joke, the benefit of the doubt, and assume that is complete joking. But she hesitated and I didn't. I just.
I couldn't get used to. Don didn't even notice it. He's like, what are you talking about? Like, no one's even staring. And I'm like,
it's the truth.
Yes, they are. They're staring. So it was definitely a huge adjustment. I think even through the first year, it was still something that really just bothered me. And I didn't know like if I was going to be able to like get over that, because
as we were traveling to Europe, Costa Rica, and all these beautiful places, Cabo, she was getting used to it.
Yeah, no, while we...
Hold on, I muted my mic to blow my nose. Listen, is that a joke? Or is that them bringing up... Is he calling her a gold digger? Bitch. Is that the energy that just shifted for me?
We were out, though. It wasn't the same as here. Like, when you travel, it's more common than you think. Like, when we were in Europe, in Mexico, in other parts of Latin America.
She's a sugar baby, and she never was. That was one of the first conversations we had, mm-hmm. was sitting there talking about it, and I said, Myra, none of this is going to be about money. And she says, Dawn, I don't need your money. And I thought, I like the start.
Yeah, we definitely had a very... open conversation about this, because of course, like an older man, younger woman, an older man is going to be with a younger woman for sex, and a younger girl is going to be with an older man for money. So that was like one of the first things that we established
and
early on.
And we started off as friends, real friends.
I told him, I'm like, I don't need you to pay my bills. I don't need any of your money.
And I said to her, I don't need you for sex.
No, I said, and it's not going to be about sex. And don't expect that. Like, I don't expect that from you. So don't expect that from me. Like, I really want us to.
But she was all over me.
Get out of here. No, so we.
Okay, so like they are like self-aware. He said sugar baby, which makes me go, okay, you know words. Because I meet old men all the time who don't even know what that is. But like, okay, he knows words. They know words. They're talking about it. Okay.
Really did. We became really good friends. And we didn't cross that line until months into our relationship, because I really wanted us to get to know each other as friends. And so I felt like we established a really, really great foundation because of that.
Yeah, and at that point, I think we knew that if we had to do that, if we're going to go there.
What do people keep mean? I saw a couple comments that said they're like promoting the friend zone. Alfred, what do you mean they're promoting the friend zone? Like, has anyone seen the film Harold and Maude? Oh, baby, on this channel, that is like one of our favorite movies. Have you all seen it yet? I love Harold and Maude. Great movie. But they weren't a long-term relationship, right? Like, they were just connected and they were having sex. Harold and Maude, they were fuck buddies, bro. They were lovers. Like, they weren't really dating, because she done... You know what she did at the end? Not to give it away. Nobody give it away. But like, she obviously wasn't considering him in the way that a relationship would be presumed to. And you know what I'm saying? But Harold Amon is great. But okay, this is so interesting to me, because, well, let's let them finish. But what's the friend zone mean? Somebody explain that to me, because I don't know what you mean by they're promoting the friend zone.
The distance. Mm-hmm. And that's why it's lasted.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think Dawn really developed respect for me, you know, and I also appreciated him being patient. And of course, he was still like, it was, I don't know, like that didn't even really, like we didn't really think about that.
We stayed within the structure and boundaries really well.
Yeah, and we went out and we had a good time and like we just talked.
It was so much fun and we worked out and we hiked and we went to lunches and we went to dinners and you know, it took a long time. I'm teasing about Costa Rica, Europe, and all of those places. Oh. We took our time until we took off and started traveling and really became a couple.
Yeah.
Aww. And after we'd been dating for about 3 months, I thought I'd step it up. So I surprised her by booking a trip to Costa Rica.
Pause. Alfred says, not saying it's a bad thing, but it's showing that the friend zone worked there. Yes. Okay. Yes. I just read an article saying that you're most likely to find your partner if they're a friend already or friends of friends. And I think that makes sense. Like, you grow up with people, you see them outside of relationships, you don't have to worry about money or sex. So when you see them being themselves, you fall in love with who they really are instead of what they can give you. And I think that's really important. AS is new. Hi, welcome around. You know, you're new to these parts. Welcome, welcome. I hope you find a space here. Love that. But I just like, I like their self-awareness. I like that they made the jokes in the beginning that we all went, ooh, what's that about? And then they covered it and then re-had the conversation now, which is good.
Week.
Which was so much fun.
Oh, man, it was so
still
much fun.
Still to date, it's probably been, it's for sure one of our top three trips we've ever taken.
We were there for a weekend, man. We were in the water, jet skiing, monkeys everywhere. Ah, it was so much fun.
Oh, my God. If we can find the clips.
Yeah, we had fun.
Literally, I had monkeys in the villa with us, and I was like giving them grapes fun. And water. Monkeys. I'm not joking.
It was romantic. It was beautiful. So and it was the right time of year.
Yeah.
It was just amazing.
If you guys want to know how that first trip, that was the first time we had ever traveled together.
Did you make these?
Yeah, that's my
secret. Oh, that was so good.
Guys, if you want to know about that trip, how it went, it was the first time we were ever traveling together. We'll do a little story time on that. Comment down below. Let us know. If you have any ideas on another story time or like a Q&A,
okay, it's coming to the end, but look at that. He's like, oh, did you make these cookies? And like, she's like, yeah. And he's like, oh my gosh. Like, he still appreciates her. He shows appreciation. Okay, we're done with this video. She's closing up.